Are you ready to get started writing code for Arduino? If so, you are going to need to use the Arduino IDE. What you're going to learn right now is the different options you have available for the IDE, or Integrated Development Environment, that you can use with Arduino. By the end of this, you'll know which one to load onto your computer and how to actually upload code onto your Arduino board. Let's go. Before we get started, I'd love if you could take a moment to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It doesn't cost you but a click, but it really helps us bring you great content like this Arduino workshop. Thanks a ton. All right, so what I've done is navigate to the Arduino website. That's just arduino.cc, and then I clicked on this software navigation tab, and that takes me to this page where it shows kind of a bunch of different options for different IDEs. So as a reminder, IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment, and it's simply a software tool that you are going to use to write your code in, and it's also going to help you load the code into an actual Arduino board. So it's a really handy tool, and all the options on the Arduino website are free. And when I say options, you actually have three different options on this website for what IDE you want to use. They have the web editor, they have the original Arduino IDE, which is Arduino IDE 1, and then they have the future version of the Arduino IDE, which is Arduino IDE 2. Now, Arduino IDE 2 is still in development as we're speaking, but it's definitely working and you can download it and check it out. I think it's a great IDE. I'm not positive yet, but I actually think they're going to keep both of these IDEs around for a long time. So I don't think IDE 1 is going away. I think it's got a lot of great features. It's really simple to use. Nothing really gets in your way. Not to say that Arduino IDE 2 isn't great also, but it has a bit more going on than Arduino IDE 1. Now, Arduino IDE 1 and 2 are both downloads that you would download onto your computer, you know, load onto your hard drive and use. But they also have a web editor that you can set up. And so it doesn't matter what computer you're on, you can write code for your Arduino and you can upload the code that you write in the web editor onto your Arduino boards with your computer. What's great about the web editor is if you have a Chromebook or maybe you're in an educational environment, a lot of people have Chromebooks, then you can use this web editor on those Chromebooks. So let's go through the process of downloading this Arduino IDE 1. It's going to be the same for Arduino IDE 2, but let's just do this. So I'm on a Windows machine. Click this. You have the option to donate. I'm just going to download it for now. I'm going to download it to downloads. I'll double click the exe file. I want it to make changes. Something about selling your first kid. I'm just going to leave all these checked. I'm just going to leave it as this default destination folder under program files. All right, now it's completed. I'll go ahead and hit close. All right, now I've got a shortcut right on my desktop here. If I click this, it's going to open up the Arduino IDE. I'll allow access. All right, here we go. This is not super duper fancy, but this is it right here. So when you open up the Arduino IDE, it opens up a new sketch. It creates a new sketch for you with the date in there. And it fills it with two functions, void setup and void loop, which you'll learn about here shortly. But what's really important is about where these things get saved. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and save this. File, save. All right, so I'm saving this. The file name is going to be subsandwich. I'm going to hit save. So now what I want to do is show you where that actually gets saved. So I'm going to go to my documents. And if we come to documents, when you install the Arduino IDE, it creates a folder called Arduino. And if you open that folder up, there's going to be some files inside here. So libraries is where all the libraries that you save will go. And all the other sketches you save, it's going to create a folder with the name of the sketch. So we save subsandwich. And if you open that, it's going to have a file in here. And you can see the file name is also subsandwich. Now, the file extension is .eno. Old file extensions are .pde, but .eno is what you'll see. And this folder named Arduino, this is called your sketchbook folder. So if you go to File, Sketchbook, you'll see here's two programs in here. Now, I had already downloaded the Arduino IDE, and I had a little simple write program, so that's why this shows up. But if you want to get to the programs you've written, which are called sketches in Arduino, you would just go to Sketchbook, and there they would show up. But let's go to File, and let's go down to Preferences. And I want to show you this right here. This is where you set your sketchbook location. Right now, mine is under Users, Mica, Documents, and then Arduino. And you can change that here if you want. You can also change the font size. Like, we could make the font size bigger, which I usually do, so we'll make that 18. You can display line numbers if you want. So you'll see this when I save this here. But there's some important stuff that takes place in here. We won't talk about all of it right now, but I'm just going to hit OK. And now you can see we see the line numbers. Okay, cool. All right, so let's go ahead and check out one of the cool features of the Arduino IDE, and that is all the example sketches in here. So I'm going to go to File, and I highly recommend you do this as well. And I'm going to go to Examples. And in the examples, they have a bunch of example programs, a bunch of example code that you can play around with. So I'm going to go to Basics, and I'm going to go to Blink. It's going to open up a new program, new sketch here. And they've got some comments up here. Comments are things that tell you about the program, but it's not actually code. It's just more like helper text for you to understand what's going on. And Blink turns an LED on and off. So we won't talk about this code right now, but I just want to show you how to check to see if there's any errors in the code and then how to actually upload it onto an Arduino board. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my Arduino Uno and I'm actually going to plug it in with that USB cable to my computer. So I'm going to plug it in. Now, my computer, it made a little noise like, oh, hey, I recognize something. Yours may or may not, but mine does. And then I'm going to go up to Tools, Board, and I'm going to select which board I have. Now, I have an Arduino Uno, so it already recognized that for me, so I'm just going to click that. We also need to set the port. So here's the port. It's going to show me I have COM4 hooked up. I have an Arduino Uno. Maybe I have different things shown here, right? But there might be multiple ports listed here. I'm just going to go with this one right here. So I'm going to click that. So now that I have my board and my port selected, I'll be able to upload this code onto my Arduino. Now, if you look in the bottom right of the Arduino IDE, it'll tell you what board you have and what port it's on. And then this space right here in this black space, this console space, it's going to show you if you have any errors or anything like that. So the first thing I'm going to do is hit this little check mark. This is the verify. And what it's doing is it's checking your sketch for any errors. Now, since this is an example sketch, we're not going to see any errors. So we get a little message down here about how much space it's using, and we're doing just fine. So now I want to actually get it onto my Arduino board. So I'm going to go ahead and hit upload. Now, when I hit upload, now it's actually uploading it to my Arduino board. And if you look at your board while it's uploading, you'll see the TX and RX lights start blinking. Now, what this program does is it blinks an onboard LED on the Arduino Uno. So most Arduinos, they have an LED on the board somewhere. Usually it's a pin 13, but not always. And as you can see, right now we're blinking the LED. So we are able to successfully upload this to the board. And so it's on for a second and off for a second. But if, let's say we wanted to speed that up, we could mess around with this delay function. And we'll talk more about this later, so don't get too worried. But I just want to just show you how this can work. So I'm just going to make that 100 and this... let's make it 75, and then I'm going to go ahead and upload it again. So now I can see the LED is blinking much faster, and it's not off as long as it is on, so it's kind of a neat little effect. Okay, so that's uploading code to the board. That's not too crazy, right? So that's about everything you need to know on a very basic level about how to get code loaded onto your Arduino board. I highly recommend going into File, Examples, and just walk through each of these examples. See the circuit they talk about setting up, and then playing around with those circuits. Just doing that is really going to help you find your way around. All right, so this is Arduino IDE 1.0. For kicks, let's check out Arduino IDE 2.0. All right, the license agreement. I'm going to install it for everybody who uses a computer, and I want to say, yep, that's okay. Again, selling my children. Now, what's nice is you can have Arduino IDE 1 and Arduino IDE 2 installed on your computer at the same time. No issues there, so I'll get hit install. And then I'll just click finish. All right, and it automatically opens the Arduino IDE 2.0 for you. Now, I had already had it installed. You might have to click to install some drivers while you go through that process, but it's just acknowledging that some drivers are getting installed. And it looks pretty darn similar, doesn't it? So you're going to have File and Preferences, and you'll notice that the sketchbook location is the same for IDE 1 and for IDE 2. So when you save a sketch in IDE 2, it's going to also you'll also be able to access it from IDE 1. No problem at all. Okay, and you can also you can change the theme to a different, you know, colored theme in there too if you wanted to do that. Kind of fun to do. I'll just keep it with this theme. Now, if I want to connect a board, I can just go to Tools, Board, and select my board. Notice this is Arduino AVR boards. There's different types of boards that you can have show up here. We won't cover how to show the different boards, but got a really big list here, and I'm just going down and saying, yep, Arduino Uno. And then I go back to Tools, Port, and the only port it's showing me is currently this COM4 Arduino Uno port, so I'll select that. And then you'll notice just right here, it's going to show me my options. If I had other boards here, it would show me those. And then again, down in the bottom right, it's telling me what board I'm connected to and the port that I'm on. The verify button is the exact same, and the upload button is also the same. So I can go to File, Sketchbook. I can see there was that sub sandwich sketch that we had saved. I can go to Examples and see all those examples. I'll just go to Blink again. Now on Arduino IDE 2.0, this is going to open up a new window. So go ahead and open this up. It's the same sketch, nothing different there. And just verify that, yep, this is the port I've got selected, and I can go ahead and upload. And the output shows down here. All right, and that's pretty much Arduino IDE 2.0. So pretty darn similar, huh? Not too much different there. Now let's talk about the web editor. So I'll go ahead and click Code Online. And what you have to do is set up an account. I've already done that. All right, so here I am. Now I'm logged in to the Arduino web editor. But in order to actually upload a sketch with the USB port, you have to install some software. It's the Arduino Agent. So this little thing pops up. I'm just going to go ahead and click that, and it's going to walk me through setting it up, making sure it's installed. So I'm going to install the agent and then select for a Windows 32 or a Windows 64. I've got a Win64, so I'll download for that. I'll double-click the installer. Just hit some next. Yep, I'm going to accept selling my kiddos. That looks like a good installation directory. All right, I am planning on using this with Google Chrome or Firefox, so I'm not going to click yes. These are the two I plan on working it on. So here we go. And now I'll hit next. It's going to go ahead and install that. And then it launches the agent. It just kind of runs in the background. Finish it. Now when you look down at your toolbar, you'll see this little Arduino looking thing, and this is the agent right here. So you can actually click this. It's going to take you right to the web IDE. If you go to the create, it'll open up a tab for you. And what we're going to be working with is the web editor. All right, so now I'm all connected. All right, so now what I do if I want to select the board is I just click here, and it's going to show me the boards I have. So here's an Arduino Uno. I select that. Cool. And then over here, it's got the different things. So I can go to Examples, Basics, Blink. Here's that sketch that we just saw on our desktop. Same thing here. And then I'll click Upload. Same thing happens. The TX and RX lights turn on and off. And I have successfully uploaded the board. So same thing here. And when you save sketches, they get saved over in your sketchbook folder, but this is an online sketchbook folder. So, you know, I've used this before, so we've got some code in here, but it just gets saved over in here and you can organize it and you can access these from anywhere. So that's pretty cool. So which one of these are you supposed to use? Well, here's the good news. It doesn't really matter. Just pick one and go with it. Now, if you are on a Chromebook computer, then you're gonna have to go with that Arduino web editor. But otherwise, you know, IDE 1, IDE 2, it doesn't really matter. There's also other editors out there that, you know, we're not going to talk about right now that you could write this code on. For example, VS Code, you could use Platform IO. The code's going to remain the same. It's just a matter of which IDE you feel most comfortable programming in. Well, hey, if you haven't already, just make a choice and get started. Download something. Check out those examples. That's a really important step to take at this point. Now, if you have any questions at all about how to download the Arduino IDE or if you're having an issue, leave a comment below and I will answer it as best as I can. Also, while you're down there, if you could subscribe to the channel, it helps us bring you great content like this Arduino workshop, and it only costs you a click. And if you could like the video, I'd really appreciate it as well. So now that we've talked about Arduino hardware, we've got the Arduino IDE installed, we are ready to start writing some code. And that's what's going to be up next. We're going to be talking about variables, control structures, writing your own functions, and just how to actually get a program to come together for your Arduino. Not to mention those Arduino-specific functions that are super important to understand. So that's what's coming up next.